to my channel, and I know once again it has been a while again. So today's video is going to be about, I'm going to be talking about me transitioning from relaxed hair to natural hair, and the process I went through with pictures and also videos. And I'm also going to be talking about ways you can help your hair to grow, and different ways of transitioning, and the ways you can maintain your hair whilst you're transitioning as well, if people don't like to do the big chop like straight. So without further ado, let's get straight. So the first thing I want to talk about is transitioning. Transitioning is when you want to go from chemical processed hair to full on natural growing hair. And in order to do that, there's only three ways that I know of anyway that you can transition. And the first way is to stop relaxing your hair completely, and over time gradually be cutting your relaxed or chemical processed hair off. The next way I know to do it is literally cut off your hair completely and start fresh and grow again. But not all people are comfortable with doing that, because like you go to school or something and they need something to, you know, manage it with. And then the third way you could transition is you literally just grow it out and then you cut it off when it's at a reasonable length and you're happy with it. But the way I did my transitioning, guys, I mean, do what you feel comfortable with. Not everyone's comfortable with it. Oh yeah, I'm gonna cut off all of my hair and I'm gonna go out like that, or I'll be putting wigs on. But not everyone's comfortable with that option. So personally, the way I transitioned was I had my I did mine gradually. When you transition, it's not just about, oh yeah, I'm gonna cut my hair and yeah, I'm gonna let it grow out. Like, it's maintenance, and you have to have that mentality of, yes, I want an afro, yes, I want natural hair. It means you have to put in the effort as well. It's just not about cutting it and leaving it to grow, because you cutting it and not maintaining it can make it even break, and damage even more if you're not conditioning it regularly, especially because you're transitioning. And when you transition, it's very important to be moisturizing your hair, because you're going through, like, your natural hair is coming from your scalp. I'm gonna make sure that you keep on moisturizing it, so you know it wants to grow. You're not preventing it from growing by not moisturizing it, if you know what I mean. Some people have to understand that transitioning is not like, oh yeah, I cut my hair, I'm on for go now, and boom, you know, you're not gonna get a massive afro straight away. Transitioning takes a lot of patience, and it can take from months to years. For me now, it's been a year and like three, four months. The thing is that everyone's hair grows at different rates. You and your friend might do the big chop at the same time, and hers might grow quicker than yours, and that's completely normal, even though you're using the same product, same everything, because everyone's hair has a different growth rate. It's just really important to have that mindset of, yes, I'm going to stick at this. It's like when you go to the gym, you know? If you don't stick to it, then you're not going to achieve the results you want. So same thing with your hair, you have to keep going at it, or else you're not going to get the results that you want. So the next thing I want to mention is demarcation. And this is where you have your curly hair. And on your curly hair, I put a picture somewhere on the side. Demarcation is the point where your process or chemical damage or whatever hair you have, like whether it's texturized, it's the line where your natural hair and your processed hair meet. Now, when I was transitioning, I didn't realize, I was actually quite scared at first, because my relaxed hair will fall out. Like, if I were to brush it, it would fall out, and that's completely normal. But me being a transitioner, not knowing anything, I was a bit scared. Or like, oh my god, my hair is coming out, and it's my natural hair that's only remaining. What if I don't have enough hair to do styles I want to do to go to school, because my texturized or relaxed hair is falling out? And yes, it's completely normal, because obviously it is chemically processed hair. Your hair is not naturally meant to be in that form. So when your natural hair is coming through, obviously that's going to be a stronger, more coarser hair compared to your chemical processed hair, which causes it to fall out even quicker, which is completely normal. And I just want to make this like really clear that it's normal for your texturized hair to fall out whilst you're going through the transitioning process, because it is weak, first of all. And if you were to get protective styles such as braids, the weight on that, your natural hair would be stronger compared to having it with just relaxed hair. Talking about the line of demarcation, as well as the chemicals that you put in previously with your hair, heat is another factor that comes into when you want to transition. If you want an afro, if you want curls, if you want all this, you know, like you see your 4C hair on Instagram, you need to stop putting heat on your hair. And I understand, yeah, if you just straighten your roots to make it blend in with your chemical process hair, it'll look fine to go out, you know, to school or whatever. It would look weird for your hair, but it's not helping your hair at all. Like, your hair wants to grow. You want your hair to grow naturally, full of curls and everything, but you're not allowing it to grow and look really healthy if you're putting heat to it. Because putting heat obviously weakens the hair, causes it to break if you do it too much. Like, it's okay. I mean, try and just minimize heat is another thing I would say. And if you really need to straighten your hair, then at least use a heat protectant, or try and see that his heatless protective styles that you can do as well. Like, there's plenty on YouTube as well that I used to follow as well. Because putting heat on your hair, especially even on your chemical, or especially on your relaxed hair, even though you've been straightening it before, I promise you, once you straighten it with your natural hair, it's still gonna look slightly different, because the natural hair part will still look more fuller compared to the ends as well. Because that's just the way that natural hair is. So I'm not one to be like judging anyone for going natural or wanting to relax hair or anything like that, because me, my afro is half red now, so I'm not the world's best, oh yes, natural hair guru. No, I'm just giving advice and what I've been through and what you guys can learn from me and not make the same mistakes as me as well. If you, like I said, if it's really a necessity that you have to use heat on your hair, just remember your hair burns at 450 degrees, so try and keep it below that if possible. Like, please, because or else you're not gonna achieve the afro you want, the curls you want. Like, what's the point of straightening your hair if you want an afro? Like, don't get me wrong, it's good to you can straighten your natural hair as you please, but just try and minimize heat if you don't want hair damage. Another thing I want to talk about is the products you use. Now, products is very important when it comes to transitioning, and using the right products is very important, very, very, very important. When you're transitioning, you have to make sure that it's not even when you're transitioning, like even when you have your chemical process hair, your relaxed hair, texture hair, you're not really meant to use sulfate based products, because what the sulfate does, that's in your shampoo, sulfate actually weakens your hair and it can actually strip your hair as well. Because what it does, the sulfate, it strips your natural oils that are naturally, you know, produced on your scalp and in your hair, which obviously causes it to become more weaker, which obviously makes it more dry and makes it more prone to breaking. So if you have a bottle of any conditioners, shampoos, just make sure you read the ingredients before you buy it, because anything that has sulfate, petroleum, which is also in vaseline, I'll explain that in a minute, you should not be using those products on your hair. Because sulfate, it, yes, when you wash your hair with the sulfate shampoo, condition it after, but you're still stripping away those natural oils that were already there, compared to when, if you wasn't using sulfate based shampoo, the natural oils will still be there, as well as the conditioner you're putting in. So it's kind of like, and it's not healthy for your hair as well. Like, I know that a lot of companies now, they're removing sulfate from their products because people are complaining about it, oh, it's damaging their hair, and it's true. But like, just try and stay away from sulfate products. Petroleum, which a lot of you guys know is in Vaseline. Even, I'm not gonna lie, I've been there where my mum puts Dax or Blue Magic on my hair when I had relaxed hair, because it makes it shiny, especially when you blow dry. It just gives it that shine look, everything. Now, I'm not saying you can't use it, but that does not moisturize your hair. In fact, petroleum, if you put it on your scalp, it actually clogs the pores of your hair follicles, which is like you're preventing it from growing, because like you put a plug in it and it's trying to, you know, grow out. So I'm not saying you can't use it, but I wouldn't advise it, because it's stopping your hair from growing if you apply it to the roots. Now, if you apply it to the ends, what it does, petroleum, because it's like a waxy kind of a product, it forms a barrier. So imagine you just put that product in and you're trying to put more moisture, shampoo, leave-in conditioner, everything, and it's not gonna enter like your actual hair, because that's forming a barrier between your hair and the products. So technically your hair is not even getting moisturized. It's literally just encoded in like this wax petroleum. Like, I know, blue magic, everything. I've been there. I'm not gonna lie, I thought it did wonders to my hair as well. I thought, yes, it was making it shiny and everything, but really it's just forming a barrier. And I mean, you can use it. I would just advise, if you were to use it, put your leave-in conditioner first and then put your wax stuff on top. It's like a waxy material, blue magic and dax. It's even harder to wash out. Another thing I want to mention, I didn't know this at first as well. I was putting like castor oil on my hair, Jamaican black castor oil on my hair, argan oil, tea, you know, all these things you're gonna put on your hair. Don't get me wrong, the oils are good for your hair, but oil is a sealer, it is not a moisturizer. And I did not know this before. I would just put oil on my hair, you know, the way it looks greasy, you know, like so glow from coming to America. Just let it shine through. Just let your soul, baby, feeling oh so silky smooth. Just let it shine through. Just let your soul. And I was just like, yeah, but like, no. I'm not saying you can't use oils, but what you have to do first is moisturize your hair, then put the oil, because the oil will seal it after. Whereas if you seal the oil first, you put the oil first and you seal it, and you put your moisturizer, it's not gonna get in because the oil is creating a barrier like the wax. So I'm talking about barriers. Porosity is another thing I need to mention. I did not know about this. Like, literally, guys, I was learning steps, you know, with my natural hair journey, and I'm just sharing my advice with you. Porosity is a very important thing, and even though we all have afros and we might think we all have the same textures, it's not true. Everyone has different porosities. Sorry if I'm saying it wrong, but it's very important to know whether you have a high porosity or a low porosity, because this will determine how much product can actually get into your hair, and I'll explain that in a minute now. So if your hair is a low porosity, then it's harder to get moisture into your hair. Whereas if your hair is a higher porosity, then it's easier to get moisture into your hair. And the way to find this out, which I didn't know, I honestly didn't know anything about this before until I did all my research whilst I was going through my journey, is to do the hair porosity test. And this works by you brushing your hair or combing it, avoiding fine combs and stuff, which I'll get into in a minute. And once you brush your hair, you place it in water 2 to 4 minutes. And if the hair floats on the water, then your hair is a low porosity. Whereas if your hair like has little bumps in it or it lifts up, then your hair is a higher porosity. So this way you'll know whether, okay, which kind of product I need to use. How am I gonna seal my hair if my hair is a low porosity, if it's a high porosity? And there's many great like natural hair websites out there that explain it in a great depth of detail of how to manage your hair depending on your porosity as well, because it's very important, especially when if you want to bleach your hair or if you want to dye your hair like I have done. Another thing that I'm guilty of whilst I was going through my transitioning stage, because this is a point where my natural hair was getting more fuller, and I was putting protective styles such as braids, wigs, just, you know, coloring my hair back like I've done now. I didn't know that, well, I did know, but I didn't take it into account until I realized when I was sleeping, you know, I'll moisturize my hair, you know, I might put it in a shower cap to, you know, condition for a bit. But it's best to put it in a silk durag or a silk bonnet, because that, you know, encloses the moisture into your hair. It lets the moisture actually get into your hair, compared to where if you sleep on your pillow, which is like usually made out of cotton, that cotton will absorb your hair products and you'll wake up with knotted, matted hair. Like, it's happened to me so many times, and I'm like, why does my hair get knotted when I wake up? Well, it's because I'm not putting a silk bonnet on it, because a silk bonnet prevents it from matting up and being tangled as well. So it's very important. And if you cannot get a bonnet or a satin durag, or a silk durag, for whatever reason, get a satin pillowcase, because honestly, like, it really does knot up your hair in the morning. And imagine you're running late and your hair's knotted and you have to do the whole process again. It's just time consuming. But like, putting that bonnet on, that do-rag, changing that pillowcase to a satin pillowcase does really help. Another thing which I want to mention, and a lot of people probably already know this, is but it's to not use fine hair tools on your hair, such as tooth combs to comb out your hair. It's okay to part it, but like, to brush it or comb it, it's not gonna happen. Like, your hair's gonna break off. You brush it, or you get a knot, you brush it and the knot goes off, that's your hair gone again. Like, our hair is not good with fine tools. We have to use like wider tools or products or detangling brushes as well, because the thin ones, they don't work, and it gets our hair even more, puts more stress in our scalp because you're pulling it and you're trying to get it through, whereas you don't need to struggle. And also another fact, little tip for you guys, is that when you're combing your hair or if you want to brush your hair, it's easier to do it when wet. And then some people were like, but what if I straighten my hair and I want to, you know, just brush it through or whatever? And it's like, you don't have to drench your hair in water. You can just spray it, brush it through, and then straighten it, or do whatever style you want, because it's easier to do it when wet than dry. And I would advise you to never brush your hair when it's dry, because it just causes more breakage. It's just easier to put that little bit of water, just help soften it a bit, and then you can continue with brushing or detangling your hair, because that prevents it from breaking. So yeah, finally, the thing I want to mention, to not compare yourself to other naturals. That can like disencourage you or make you feel down because your hair is not growing at the same rate as someone else's, or because it's not looking as moisturized or as full as someone else's. Like I said, everyone's hair grows at different rates, everyone's hair is different, we all have different hair textures. And even me, my curl pattern, one could be like 4B and then the other one could be like 4C. like, everyone's hair is different. Just make sure you love your hair, make sure it's healthy and happy. That's the most important thing. And yes, it might not look like a massive afro yet, but it takes time, patience, and you've got to keep on going with maintenance as well. So that's a very important thing I need to mention as well, because some people, they're always like, oh my gosh, I want my hair to be like yours. Why is my hair not growing as long as yours? I want my hair to be less long, full. Well, you put in the effort, you maintain it, you just keep doing what you're doing to keep your hair healthy. And eventually, with time, your hair will grow. It will surpass. It will grow. And if you don't think it's growing, you can even get a tape measure, measure one part, and keep maintaining all your hair, and you'll see the growth eventually over time. You might not see results within a couple of months, but once those couple months have gone, you might see, oh, it's grown by 1 inch, 2 inch. It just takes patience and time. And honestly, guys, like, even me, I was checking every time, oh, I want to see my hair growth. Oh, like, I was so excited, because it just felt so amazing. Like, my curls came through first time, and I saw my natural hair, and I was like, wow, this is what I've been putting all these products on to make it straight all this time. But it's okay. Well, here are some videos and pictures from my natural hair journey, and as you can see, some of them I did styles to protect my hair from looking like it was transitioning. Some I did just to, you know, go to college, or quick styles to go. I promise you guys, once I redo my cornrows, before I redo my cornrows, put my wig back on, because storm CR is causing my hair to get a bit dry, so that's why I'm putting the wig on. But once I take my cornrows out, I'll show you some natural hairstyles that I do when I want to go to college, when I go out, that are really quick, easy, simple, and when you need to go on the go. So someone just remind me as well, because I might forget, even though I'm recording this video. That's the end for today. This is the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comments below. Answer them as soon as possible when I can, because of college, and I still need to do that college video, don't I? Where I talk about unis and stuff, I will come around to it. I will try my best, guys, to be consistent. Thank you guys so much for watching. God bless, and I will see you very soon.